But I've been trying to work on my depression. I told a friend that. She told me she's never been depressed and never once thought about killing herself. I was like, what? Not one time? No, you've never sat in your car and gone, if I just drive into the ocean, I don't have to go to work on Monday if I'm just driving. It's funny how the universe will test you though. Cause I remember I came out of the house having a very emo day. I was like, fuck this shit. I don't want to be here. God wasn't real. Everything's bullshit. And then the elevator I was on stopped in between floors and just started shaking. I was immediately on my knees. I was like, dear Lord, as one of your faithful followers, if I could address the Holy Trinity, dear Buddha, Beyonce, and Dolly Parton, if I could. I came out of that elevator like an inspirational meme. I'm like, too blessed to be stressed. It was a lot. I was like, can't spell sunshine without I. It was too much. Obviously, I had to go to therapy. That is not sustainable. And this joke is a little bit dark, but you'll be fine. Also, I'm dressed like a Hot Topic manager. What did you think? I was gonna say, it's fine. It's okay, so it's dark, but you'll be good. So there was a point, I'm doing well now, where I did not want to be here. But I was like, you know what? I'm not gonna run into traffic while my mom is still alive. That felt rude, you know? But I was like, the second she's gone, I'm out of here. Which, if you know anything about Indian people, is kind of an empty threat because we live forever. Bro, that shit was so brutal. I was sitting around my house all sad. I'd get a phone call from my mom. Subhah, I just started yoga today. I was like, no! She's like, did you know kale is a superfood? I'm like, you're killing me. I can't. This is too much. Put some salt on your fries so we can all get out of here, lady. This is nuts. Obviously, I'm very happy I never did anything stupid for a couple reasons. And I didn't realize how dumb this was when I was younger, but I was raised Hindu, so I technically believe in reincarnation. Yeah. I can never actually kill myself. I can just come back as something worse. Like, do you know how embarrassing it would be if I was like, man, life is in the suburbs as a teenager is just too hard. And then I came back as a pigeon trapped in an airport. Not good. That and I don't know how to leave a note. That's too much pressure, bro. If I ran into traffic, my only note would be a Ouija board with a post-it that said TTYL. That's it. That's all I can do. But obviously, I had to get my shit together because I got married and I wanted him to stay. It's like, shit, if I wanted to stick around, I should probably stop showering with my clothes on, you know? Just. It's hard. It's hard to be with somebody who's sad all the time. Just, babe, what are you thinking about? The darkness? Like, you can't. You can't. You can't do it. But I have a lot of depression, a lot of anxiety. Those two tend to go together, which is fun. I don't like anxiety because it feels very narcissistic. Like, I'll literally trip over a crack in the sidewalk, be like, oh my God, everybody saw me. Everybody thinks I'm stupid. But the truth is, I live in Hollywood. I'm over the age of 25. I often wear no makeup. Nobody saw me. They don't tell you this when you move here. I mean, I love how shallow it is, but on a scale of hotness from 1 to 10, if you're under a 5 and not blonde, you can shoplift and nobody will see you. I'm like, oh my God, this lip gloss is floating out of this Sephora. I'm kidding, don't try that.